Trophallaxis, Pleomatrosis and Gamma Gates. What? Yes. All words to describe ant behavior and anatomy. In this video, I'm going to explain all the difficult ant words so you can understand what they mean and sound smart when talking about ants. Before we get into the names, a small disclaimer. Finding footage for all these different types of ant behavior is very hard. So not everything you will see in this video will have a direct connection with the word I'm talking about. Also, turn on the subtitles for a better understanding of these difficult words. Alright, without further ado, let's start with a few commonly used words. The first one being trophallaxis. Trophallaxis basically means an ant transferring food or other fluids to other ants. This mouth-to-mouth process is used to make sure all ants in the colony are fed, and that some workers never need to leave the nest. You can see trophallaxis happen every time you feed your ants. It looks like they are giving each other kisses. When performing trophallaxis, food gets transferred out of the ant's social stomach. The social stomach is a secondary stomach which is used to store food for other ants. The next word is polygyne and monogyne. These words are often used when describing the queen count of colonies. You guessed it, colonies with multiple queens are polygyne. Poly meaning more and gene meaning queen ant. Monogyne is the exact opposite, meaning the colony can only have one queen. Some queens can perform polygynous behavior, but after the founding phase the strongest queen will kill the other queens. You can see this happen with Lazy's Niger, where the queens can stay in founding stage together but will kill each other after. Check out this video from Ant Holofer, where he experiments with multiple founding Lazy's Niger queens. Multiple founding Lazy's Niger queens behavior can also be described with the word pleomatrosis, which means queens can tolerate each other during the founding stage. Pleomatrosis often occurs to boost the colony and increases the chances of a colony's survival. Oligyny is a form of polygyny, where only the workers will tolerate queens, while the queens will fight, which is why workers usually separate queens and keep them from harming each other. This happens with Lazy's Flavus, where after the founding stage workers will move the queens into different parts of the nests. One extreme form of ant-laying queens are gamma gates. Gamma gate is the word used for workers that can be fertile. In most cases, after a queen dies, a worker can be fertilized. This happens in species like Harpogonathus venator, but other species are specialized to only have gamma gates like Diachema. In summary, gamma gates are words that can produce fertilized eggs after the previous queen dies. Usually, the most dominant worker becomes the new gamma gate. In some species, they do this by fighting. Species have different fighting styles to assert dominance. After all the mating is done, the first workers are being born. These are called nanitics, and they are the queen's first generation of workers. These workers often specialize in taking care of the queen after a harsh founding period. So, nanitics are not other ants. They are usually smaller due to less food. Just the first generation of workers being born. After a while, the queen will lay more and more eggs. Then the process of physogastrism can occur. This usually happens when an ant is full of food. That's called false physogastrism. Or a queen or gamma gate ovaries are swollen to increase egg production through physogastrism. So, in summary, a queen full of eggs is called physogastrism. Ant with swollen gas from food is called false physogastrism. Another way of getting brood is to go and steal some from a neighboring colony. Dulotic species they are called, and they are species of ants that raid other colonies for their brood during and after founding stage. They do this to boost their own numbers and quickly grow their colonies. After the queen mates, she pulls out her wings to get energy from breaking down her wing muscles. She's called an ergetoid, meaning a permanent wingless queen. After founding, a lot of species will enter diapause, which is a period of suspended development, commonly occurs during colder temperatures in winter to preserve energy. It's not the same as hibernation, because the ants don't regulate their heat. Moving on to other words that describe ant behaviors. A commonly used word is polymorphism. This is a term given to species which display multiple castes, which can include minim, minor, media, major, supermajor, etc. Monomorphism is the opposite and means that there is only one distinct caste. This is almost always just the worker caste, and you can see it on species like Lasius Niger. Some of these castes can do some amazing things with their bodies, like blocking the entrance of a tunnel or ant nest. This is called phragmosis. You can see this in turtle ants. Another cool thing ants can do is use certain types of ants as food storage. These are called replates. A replate is a specialized caste of ant made to store food in their social stomachs to an extreme proportion. Most people know them as honeypot ants. The last word is mammicophile, which is an invertebrate or plant which has a symbiotic relationship with ants, such as being tended and protected by ants or living inside an ant's nest. For example, aphids who get tended to by the ants and provide honeydew in return. Whoa, those were a lot of hard and difficult words. How many did you know already? And which ones were completely new to you? Let me know in the comments. If you want to get some more information about these words, I included all the source material in the description down below. If you think we missed some words, let me know. We might do a part 2 on this. Thank you so much for watching this video. I hope you learned something. This video was made in collaboration with the EA Helper team. A special thanks to all members who helped with this episode. When performing trophallaxis, food gets transferred out of the... That's why workers usually separate the genes, the queens... Then the process of psycho... Or a queen or gamergate ovaries. Ovaries. This usually happens when an ant is full of food. That's called false psycho... This usually happens when an ant is full of food. That's called false physiogastrism. This usually happens when an ant is full of food. That's called false or a queen or gamergate ovaries. That's called false psychogastrism. Godverdomme. This usually happens when an ant is full of food. That's called false psychogastrism. This usually happens when an ant is full of food. That's called This usually happens when an ant is full of food.